How you doing, folks? I'm Andy. This is Now Guitar, the channel where I teach you to play songs acoustically so that you can play them without a band. It's all designed for the beginner to intermediate levels with the aim of you being able to perform them acoustically, maybe with a singer or by yourself. So, to aid in that, I give you, with every single lesson, a free song guide, one-page song guide you through what I'm teaching in the lesson, and it's absolutely free. Available to grab in the description down below or the first comment. Go and grab it now. I'll be making reference to it as we go. So as I was saying, with performance in mind, I've noticed over the years when I've gone to teach this to students that a lot of people really get caught up with this slightly lilted picking pattern here with this uneven timing. So if you're going to perform this, I have kept it as bare bones as possible. We're strumming it rather than doing the picking. There's a zillion lessons out there for the song with the picking. So use this as your foundation to build on top of, and then go and learn from those other lessons if you want to do the picking as well. So with that in mind, what are the chords? So they are A minor, C, D, F, which is the first four chords, incidentally. We've got E, and we've got E7. If you know the other E7 with your fourth finger, feel free to do that. Either of them are going to work just fine. And D minor pops up right at the end. That's our chords. What are we doing for our rhythm? It is a waltz feel. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Bunches of three is the basic gist of it. Down, down, up, down. Down, down, up, down. Once you got that, try it on a chord. All right, let's go slowly and move through these chords, referencing the sheet as we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, A minor, C, D, F, A minor, C, E, E7, A minor, C, almost the same as the first time, D, F, A minor, E. Now you'll notice the double line that I've got there. What this has is kind of these weird repeats of almost the same, not quite the same. So that's why I've put that bar line there, to make it clear that we're almost going back to the same thing after that double line. So A, C, D, F again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, A minor, C, D, F. Here's where it's different. A minor, E, A minor, E. So you can really think of that in two sections, the way that I've split it up there with the double line looking at the song guide. So once you got that, you can then step it up and try it a little bit faster. If you found that tricky to keep up with, obviously you need to know these chords under your fingers already. One way that you can do as a little intermediate step is to single strum or two strums. So 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Start simple. Two strums per bar, A minor, A minor, C, D, F, A minor, E. Here's that double line, A minor, down, down, D, then F, it's A minor, to E, A minor. The song is still there. It is very much a chord progression based song, so you don't have to be all super fancy with your strumming straight away if you find that troubling at all. So that is it for the song until you get to the outro, which is just A minor, D minor. Four times. A minor. You'd ask for an encore? Do it all over again. Let's take it up to speed. One, two, three, four, five. If you'd like to go the next step and add the picking, I've got a great intermediate way of getting you there. But to make that happen, I'm going to need 200 likes. Get me 200 likes, and then when that's happened, whoever sees that first, send me a private message through nailguitar.com, and I will make that happen once we get up to that count. So there it is for you. If you've enjoyed this lesson, giving you something different rather than everyone else teaching you the original picking, but then only, you know, falling flat on your face. The whole gist with nail guitar is getting you to a level to where you can actually perform songs. Doesn't matter whether it's planned for on stage at Wembley Stadium, maybe at school with a few people, maybe to a few friends, maybe at a barbecue, maybe at a party, maybe just to a single friend, maybe to a family member, maybe just to your cat. The gist is you want to be able to play it competently. You want to be able to nail it. You don't want to be able to play something messily, but note for note. Stop getting caught up in this whole note for note thing if you can't play it. Play something well. And if that means simplifying it, then absolutely do that. And this is where the whole thing of if you're playing with a singer or you're singing yourself, you realize that you've got to have it down. Getting there and doing extra stuff, if you're falling flat on your face, then you can't perform it. So that is the core of the nail guitar ethos. If you would like to learn more easy songs, then I've got a great resource for you. It's called the Easy Songs Cheat Sheet, and it is sneaking up close to the 50 easiest songs that I've taught here on Nail Guitar over the last 10 years. It has a link to each of those 50 easiest songs, also shows you the chords in each of those songs. Just what I would have liked when I was learning guitar, so I've created it for you guys. It is available in the link down below. Tell you all about that right now. Have fun playing your axe. Save countless hours searching for easy songs to learn and download my Easy Songs Cheat Sheet. Click the link in the description now to get it absolutely free.